another TikTok trend. And this is one that actually relates to me to some extent because I am a self-diagnosed ADHD. Guys, I am self-diagnosed. I have ADHD 100%. I'm self-diagnosed. Okay, but I just want to clarify, everyone is fucking ADHD at this point. I'm honestly so fucking tired of literally everyone in the world. Oh God, my life is so torturous because I have ADHD. Everyone does. Literally everyone does at this point. Like, we're all fucked, man. We're all fucked. But for those who don't have ADHD or for those who don't understand it, basically, there are situations when you have ADHD where you can't do things that normal people would assume are just really fucking easy to do and will call you lazy. So like, for example, I have a problem where my attention span, if you want to call it, only gravitates toward a specific thing that day. Like, for example, music. Like, some days I'm like, I got a rock hard boner for music. And then other days I'm like, hell no. Let's move on to, drawing. Oh, I'm a rock hard boner for drawing. Oh, I have a rock hard boner for doing chores. You know, it's just like you kind of selectively, your brain selectively picks the things that it wants you to do. Yeah, you're following the dopamine. That's a good way to put it. I like that. But there's this trend on TikTok called time blindness, which is fucking stupid. Basically, ADHDers are saying that you are literally so blind to time that you can't show up to work on time. That's like the whole situation at hand. Let's just watch this video first and then we'll talk about it. All right, every time I full screen, it plays the audio of a different fucking video. I don't understand Reddit, man. All right.
Just got yelled at for asking a very reasonable. So I'm applying to go somewhere and I just wanted to know, are there accommodations for people who struggle with time blindness and being on time, you know? And then the person I was with interrupted and acted like I was asking something else, and then when we were done, they actually started yelling at me and saying that accommodations for time blindness doesn't exist, and if you struggle with being on time, you'll never be able to get a job, you know, provided you're trying your absolute best to be there. And then they're like, your stupid generation wants to destroy the workplace. And yeah, I think that a culture where workers are just cut off because they struggle with being on time, when there's other solutions that we can look to, I think that just anybody who thinks it's okay to just treat people like that, yeah, that culture needs to be dismantled. And then I asked that person, how can you feel good about yourself upholding this kind of system? And then to think, I'm entitled. No, if people think it's okay to treat others like this, that's entitlement.
All right. So that's the video in question. And Runner, yeah, we're going to get to that. So let's talk about time blindness a little bit. It is real. I would like to mention it is real. But it's basically that, I'll just read this. Time blindness refers to your inability to accurately measure time. It's frequently seen in people with neurodevelopmental disorders like ADHD and autism. ADHD includes a range of hyperactive and inattentive symptoms that affect children and adults with ADHD. So, basically, it's the concept of, yeah, 3 hours feels like 30 minutes or 30 minutes feels like 3 hours. Your internal clock is kind of just, what's the word? What's the word I'm looking for? Not concrete, but abstract. Your internal clock is literally just an abstract concept. So, the reason everyone's complaining with this girl is the fact that she said that she struggles with time blindness and she's worried that she won't get to work on time. Why the fuck would you tell a job that you are applying for that you're not going to show up on time? Regardless, if it is a uncontrollable situation, which I just want to mention, it is controllable because there is a thing called clocks, you know? Yes, I highly agree. There are situations in my life and many other people's lives where time just loses, like you lose yourself in time and 3 hours disappears in 1 second, right? But there's things called alarms and there's things called clocks. You set alarms. That's how you get to work on time. You think I'd fucking wake up in time every day of my life to take my son to school without a clock, without an alarm? Like, that's the reason this shit's fucking hilarious to me. But let's move on and watch some more videos.
What are you doing? I told you to take the laundry out of the dryer at 3 o'clock.
Oh, yeah, I will. I promise.
3:30, and I just did it. So what have you been doing?
Oh my gosh.
I swear only 15 minutes has gone by. I did not realize it's been a whole hour. I was tidying up my desk, and I guess I spent the whole hour deep cleaning it. Oh my gosh, I'm really hungry. How did I not notice?
See, the reason I find this fucking hilarious is this. Okay, don't get me wrong. I feel like it is more extreme in people who have, you know, ADHD and autism and other things like that. However, this happens to everyone. This happens to everyone. There are times I literally stare at a fucking wall and then like 10 minutes pass by. Shit like that happens all the time. These people might just be dumb. No, they're not dumb. They are basically playing a victim card for something that everyone deals with and that other people deal with more extreme than others. The thing that's fucking annoying is that they're acting like this is like a huge ordeal where they think that they can't set an alarm or they can't look at a clock. Yeah, it's literally just daydreaming and spacing out, which I am a big advocate for the whole, neurodivergent ADHD situation. But the dumb thing is these are very manageable situations. Like, these things are so manageable. And these are also things that everyone deals with. Oh, this is her.
People ask me, how does it scroll and have everybody bashing you constantly on Twitter and Instagram? And all I could say is it's a testament of what the United States has become. And we hear about algorithms, political radicalization, and how...
Oh, that's a bit of a jump. Wait. When did political radicalization come? I thought we were talking about time blindness. Where did the what? This isn't politics. This is a clock.
And how the internet is influencing humans. And we think, oh, okay. But then when it happens to you, you see how big of a problem it is. Because when we can no longer have a civil discussion about a video with very little context, it makes you wonder, is there even a future for our nation? And what future?
Okay. In all fairness, okay. In the video, you were tearing up. That's number one, is you were tearing up. Doesn't look good for you in the situation. Because number two, to normal people, which you should realize this, as someone who deals with these situations, you should realize that normal people look at this stuff like you're being lazy. That's what people with depression, remember? You guys remember that? How people act with depression? People who don't have depression look at depressed people and be like, oh, stop being bummed out. Stop being sad. People don't, like, they don't think that way because they don't comprehend it. They don't understand it, right? And you should know that. So first of all, you're crying. And second of all, why the hell would you tell a job that you're applying for that you're not going to show up to work on time? Who cares if you have time blindness? If that's, you know, a big deal for you. I don't know, because maybe some people have such difficult time blindness, they literally can't function. But you do not tell a workplace that you're going to fucking do that.
There's there to fight for. Because arousing mass amounts of hate, judging people, making mass assumptions, and being stuck in a cognitive loop without even knowing it, and then doing...
Okay, I've done none of those things. I'm being very fair to you, by the way.
Doing exactly what the algorithms want is seen as normal. But you know what? It doesn't have to be. When people ask me, how does it feel being the time blindness girl, and how...
I'm trying to be as fair as physically possible, because I don't like being like, you're stupid! You're stupid! You know? I don't like being that guy. But man, sometimes it's hard.
Actually started yelling at me and saying that accommodations for...
Okay, this is just a react video. Alright, let's see.
But time blindness is literally a you problem only.
The stuff you said and the specific wordage that you used says to me that you truly don't understand that this symptom, time blindness, is a disability.
Okay, we're starting to throw disability around a little bit too much, guys. Guys, I think the word disability has lost its meaning. What? What? Okay, if time blindness is a disability, then daydreaming is a disability. Then forgetting what when you're walking into a kitchen and you forget what you're doing, that's a disability. Common memory loss, that's a disability. Okay, we really need to stop throwing that word around like it's just candy. You can't do that. All right, let's see what she has to say. Maybe she'll fix. I don't know. Maybe she'll clarify. We'll see.
It is something that disables us from being able to function in everyday life.
Wait. I'm just going to say it. If it is so bad that you can't function, which I just want to say, I don't know that. Maybe that's the case. So let's all humor her for a second. That is the case. She can't control it. It is very detrimental to her life. Just set a bunch of alarms. Okay, in 2 hours, I have to do this. Siri, set an alarm for 2 hours. Time blindness fixed. It has been cured. Like, it literally, carry a timer around with you. Have like a little beeper in your pocket. Like, it's not that hard. If it's so like debilitating to you to where it ruins your entire life, why are you not doing everything you can to fix it or help that situation instead of just whining about it on the internet?
What you clearly see this as is a flaw within an individual, when in reality, it is fundamentally a different way in which someone else perceives time. And
yes, I understand completely what she is saying, like what I was talking about with the depression thing. People who don't understand depression think people are just being sad. But this is one of those cases that are easily fixable, you know?
You expect us to only accommodate ourselves for everyone else. You expect the outside world to even help us achieve those accommodations for ourselves? Because I don't think you do. Because you don't see it as a disability. You talk about how broken the system is, but then you go and defend that same system by telling us that's not how the real world works. Your entire video can be summed up as your new little TikTok echo chamber, thinking that you can get what you want, but in the real world, it doesn't work like that. OP literally did nothing.
I mean, like, it's just, I really don't know what else to say except alarm, you know? And if you have an issue forgetting an alarm, like where it's such a debilitating thing where you can't even remember to set an alarm, set an alarm for every hour, set an alarm for every 15 minutes. So you know when that alarm goes off, you know what time it is. You know, with depression, for example, something that is debilitating and can ruin your life, you can't set an alarm on depression. You can't set an alarm on, say, anger issues. That's something that can be debilitating for people. Or, like, autism. I mean, that's a spectrum, obviously, but I'm saying, like, some type, or, like, nonverbal autist. You can't set an alarm on that. You know what I mean? You can't.
Nothing wrong by asking in a direct and straightforward way if these people would be able to accommodate her disability. You literally said in your video that there are jobs where you can be accommodated for this, but then you're also saying it's unreasonable for people to accommodate this. Again, OP did nothing wrong, and there were serious disabling symptoms that come along with ADHD.
Okay, but how do jobs accommodate you not showing up on time? That's my question. She's saying that the world doesn't want to change for them, but how do you expect them to change? Do you just expect them to be like, hey, you could show up whenever you want, leave whenever you want, you know? I consider myself a very sympathetic, but also yelling at other people and complaining about an easily solvable problem doesn't help anyone. Yeah.
It's a middle ground where you can learn to manage your time blindness. Manage because you can't get rid of it. And there are ways.
I mean, that is a good point. Work from home on your own schedule. True. That's something you could do. I'll work for 27 hours, but you could pay me for 40, right? Because to me, it was 40 hours. Dude, that's actually genius. You could just fake time blindness. Be like, how long has it been? 40 hours? You could pay me for 40, right? wait, we just found a way to game the system. Yeah, but okay, I really can't feel sympathy for these people because, like, there are so many solutions. That's the annoying part. Because I'm always going to give people the benefit of the doubt. Let them, you know, maybe this is a genuine thing that is so debilitating that you can't do anything like a normal person. But there's so many so many ways to solve this, you know?
Oh my God, please tell me that this is a parody account.
So I just got yelled at for asking a very reasonable.
Okay, I do want to watch this because it's an old lady. I'm kind of curious. After this, we can be done with this topic. I just want to see the old lady.
So I'm applying to go somewhere and I just wanted to know, are there accommodations for people who struggle with time blindness and being on time, you know? And then the person I was with interrupted and acted like I was asking something else. And then when we were done, they actually started yelling at me and saying that accommodations for time blindness doesn't exist. And if you struggle with being on time, you'll never be able to get a job, you know, provided you're trying your absolute best to be there. And then they're like, your stupid generation wants to destroy the workplace.
And yeah, I think that a culture where workers are just cut off because they struggle with being on time when there's other solutions
I'm ready, dude.
Can look to, I think that just...
I'm ready to hear what she's got to say.
Person, how can you feel good about...
Okay.
...have time blindness.
Ready?
Oh my God. You don't have time blindness. That's Let's not see. A thing. What you do have is a case of massive disrespect and disregard.
Oh boy. It's the boomer take. Yes. I was hoping with every fiber of my being. Please say that people don't want to work these days. Please say that kids don't want to work these days. I'm begging you, say the line. You got to say the line.
For anyone else around you, because you're acting like an entitled, lazy moron. All you have to do is freaking set your alarm clock earlier. This isn't rocket science. What you have is not a disability. It's not a health problem. It's not some sort of mental deficiency. It's a bad freaking habit. You can fix this.
Damn, grandma. Pull back a little bit, girl. Damn. I mean, she basically said it, guys. She basically said it. We all heard it. Damn. That was entertaining. I loved that. I love that situation.
Now it's time to walk away. I hope you enjoyed your stay. Did you laugh or cry or maybe subscribe? I'll thank you either way. You know I will miss you. I hope you return. Tell your friend or your mother to get me more views, please.